pedestrian trail. Today we'll be revising the question answers and some important points from this lesson. So first we will see some important points to remember from the lesson. So when was the founding of the Industrial Finance Corporation of India? So it was founded in the year 1948. Founding of the Industrial Finance Corporation of India, 1948. Now, what was the purpose of Industrial Finance Corporation of India? So the purpose was making long-term loans available for industrial projects. Founding of the Industrial Development Corporation. So it was founded in the year 1954. Industrial Development Corporation was founded in the year 1954. Purpose of the Industrial Development Corporation. So what was the purpose? To boost development of the industrial sector. The industry that forms 14% of total industrial production. So which is that industry that contributes 14% of total industrial production? It is textile industry. Textile industry forms the 14% of the total industrial production. Whatever all the industries produce from that 14% is the contribution of the textile industry. States where silk industry is concentrated or where the silk industry is practiced. So the states are Karnataka, Andhra Pradesh, West Bengal, and Jammu and Kashmir. Even in tribal areas, now silk industries have started. Top ranking country in jute production. So India is the country which ranks on the top for jute production. Your production of jute is done on the large scale. A market mechanism that helps craftsmen from rural and urban areas to get a market for their wares. So that market is Delhi Haat. The sunrise sector of India. Okay, so which industry is called the sunrise sector of India? That is automobile industry. Automobile industry is called the sunrise sector of the India. Biggest tractor industry in the world. So India is the biggest tractor industry in the world. India produces tractors on the major scale. So it is the biggest tractor industry in the world. Regions to which India exports tractors. Okay, so which are the countries where India exports tractors. Okay, so India exports tractors to Turkey, Malaysia, and several countries in Africa. The industry that is mainly export oriented. Okay, so the industry which prepares the products and that products are mainly exported. So that is called export oriented. So the industry that is mainly export oriented is leather industry. Okay, so leather items, whatever are made like purses, bags, shoes, belts, etc., these items are exported. These are sent to other countries for the sale. Annual production of salt in India. So 200 lakh tons of iodized salt and 60 lakh tons, okay. Leading producer of bicycles in the world. So India is the leading producer of bicycles in the world. Centers of bicycle production. Now in India, where the where is cities or states where cycles are produced? So it is Punjab, especially Ludhiana and Tamil Nadu. Countries to which India exports bicycles. So India exports also bicycles to other countries like Nigeria, Mexico, Kenya, Uganda, Brazil. Objectives to Khadi and Village Industry Commission. So what were the objectives of establishing Khadi and Village Industry Commission? So first point is to develop traditional industries, handicrafts, cottage industries, and second objective is to make villages self-reliant by creating employment there. The industry which provided jobs for 70% of Indians. So as agriculture is the main occupation in India, so 70% jobs are provided from the agriculture field, okay? So the industry which provides job for 70% of Indians is agriculture. Provisions contained in the industrial licensing policy of 1970. Factories requiring an investment of more than 5 crore rupees to be included as heavy industry. So this was the provision contained in the industrial licensing policy of 1970. Responsibility of conservation of forest. So what is the responsibility of conservation of forest? Why forest should be conserved? Who's responsible for the conservation of forest? The central and state governments and the local people are the responsible for conserving of forest. So industries which depend on raw material from forest. Okay, there are industries which are based on forest. Okay, so which are the industries like they which depend on forest? So construction. So for construction, wood is required. Like construction, paper, newsprint, silk, matchboxes, medicinal herbs, honey, lacquer, paint. So these are the industries which depend for their raw material from the forests. They obtain their raw material from the forests. Measures adopted for developing the fisheries industry. Now for development of fishing, okay, what were the measures? So first point is building of harbors. Second point, redevelopment of old harbors. And third point is fish seeding incubation centers. Fourth point, fishing industry training centers. Okay, so for the development of fishing industry, these measures were adopted. India's major imports. So what are the things which India imports from the other countries, which India buys, okay? Machines, iron, mineral oil, fertilizers, medicines. India's major exports. Okay, so exports means the products which are sent from India to the other countries for selling. Okay, so it is tea, coffee, spices, cotton, textiles, leather, footwear, pearls, and precious stones. So you have to remember the things which are the major imports and major exports of India. You have to remember those things. India's important ports: Mumbai, Kolkata, Cochin, and Chennai. Some dates and events are there. Just we'll have a look. 1948, Industrial Finance Corporation of India was set up. 1954, Industrial Development Corporation. Was set up, and in 1963, Textile Committee Act was set up. In 1970, Industrial licensing policy declared that factories requiring an investment of more than 5 crore rupees were to be included in heavy industries. And in the year 1951, economic planning started. So these are the important dates and events that took place in the progress of his industries. Now choose the correct option and rewrite the complete answer. Here you have to choose the answer from the options and you have to write this again. When you solve the paper, you just write the options. Okay, so there it is mentioned over here. Choose the correct option and rewrite the complete answer. So first one, in 1948, Industrial Finance Corporation of India was formed for making, option B, making available long-term loans to industrial projects. Second fill in the blank, dash industry in India is called the sunrise sector. Answer is option B, automobile. Automobile industry in India is called the sunrise sector. Third fill in the blank, the major responsibility of the textile committee is? Option B, determining the quality standards of cloth. To set the quality standards of the cloth. Fourth fill in the blank is, dash is the major Indian city in the production of bicycles. So answer is option B, Ludhiana. Ludhiana is the major Indian city in the production of bicycles. Okay, so just we will solve textual questions first. When afterwards we will see the extra questions. Now question 1B is given here. Identify the wrong pair and correct it. But the question, you get only the question like this. Identify the wrong pair. So you have to just identify it and write it down, which is the wrong pair. I'll read the question. Number one, Industrial Finance Corporation of India makes long-term loan available for industrial projects. Second, Industrial Development Corporation develops of industrial sector, development of industrial sector. Third, Textile Committee, welfare of weavers. And fourth is Khadi and Village Industries Commission, promotion of industrialization in rural areas. So the answer, the wrong pair is Textile Committee, welfare of weavers. Because textile committee sets the quality standards for textile. You have to just identify the wrong pair, okay, and write it. There is no need to correct it and write it. Question number two from the wrong pair. First one, bicycle, Ludhiana. Second, Seribiotic Research Laboratory, Nagpur. Third is tractor export, Africa. And fourth is port for trade, Mumbai. So wrong pair over here is second, Seribiotic Research Laboratory, Nagpur. Because Seribiotic Research Laboratory is situated in Bangalore, not in Nagpur. So it's the wrong pair is Seribiotic Research Laboratory, Nagpur. Just we'll solve textual question. Question number two, do as directed, complete the table. So as I told you, you have to remember the goods imported in India and goods exported from India. You have to fill that table. So when planning started, goods imported in India, when planning started in 1951, the import of industrial goods and raw material required for production increased. India's imports, now these are the things which India imports. India's imported included machines, iron, minerals. mineral oil, fertilizers, medicines, etc. Goods exported from India. So India also gave impetus to exports after independence in order to gain valuable foreign exchange. India's exports included tea, coffee, spices, cotton, textiles, leather, footwear, pearls, precious stones, etc. So these are the goods which are imported in India and goods exported from India. Okay, so it import and exports comes in concept map also. So it easily you can write the answers. Import, export. We'll see question number 2B1. Explain the concept. Question number 1, internal trade of India. Answer. First point, India's internal trade takes place through railways. So how does India's internal takes place? So India's internal trade takes place through railways. Waterways means through rail, through water. Okay, like from the ships, then roads, airways, etc. Ports like Mumbai, Kolkata, Cochin, and Chennai are important. Second point, commodities like now, what are the things which are sent throughout the country or within the country? So commodities like coal, cotton, cotton textiles, rice, wheat, raw jute, iron, steel, oil seeds, salt, sugar, etc. are included in internal trade. Okay, these are the things which are taken in the which are the things sent in the country, within the country, from one city to another city. Third point, due to the development of industries, the standard of life in the country improves. As industries are developed, as industries are progressed, so the qualities of the standard of the living of the people also improves. Due to the development of industries, the standard of life in the country improves. Fourth point, many opportunities for employment become available. On the whole, it helps in the progress of the country. So these are the points of internal trade of India. Question number 3A, explain the following statements with reason. First, question number first, the tourism industry has developed to a great extent in India. Okay. So why the tourism industry has developed to a great extent? Answer, first point, India has a rich cultural heritage. There are places of worship of different religions, pilgrimage centers, confluences of rivers, forts, caves, etc. all over our country. As we all know, like in India, there are many places to visit, beautiful places, beautiful gardens are there, monuments, historical monuments are there, pilgrimage centers are there, okay? And confluences of rivers, forts, etc. many things are there, and so which people come over here to visit. Second point, tourists from our country as well as from other countries. Tourists from our countries as well as from abroad travel in India throughout the year. Okay, for visiting these sites, these places, tourists travel throughout the year from India also, people from within the country and from the outside the country also, people come here for visiting throughout the year. Third point, the facilities for tourists to stay, travel, etc. are provided through the Tourism Development Corporation. And the sale of curios and the hotel industry thrives in tourist places. In some places, there are guides who give information to tourists about that area. So there are guides. Okay, suppose if you are visiting any historical site, so there are guides. They tell us the story about that place. They give us the information when it was established, what was the important point. Okay, these all things they discuss with us. And many people come over here. So tourist corporation, they see to the facilities of the stay and travel. So in this way, hotel industry also grows. Fourth point, sometimes when the vehicles don't reach the destination in some remote areas and difficult to reach the tourist places, the local people help the tourism, help the tourist in return for a fee. So sometimes it happens like the road is not proper, like a vehicle is not moving on that vehicle, or some problem is there. So the remote people, the village people over there, the local people from the village, they will help the tourist in reaching that place, and in return they'll be getting the fee. So this gives rise for employment. Fifth point, employment opportunities are generated out of these needs. Thus, the tourism industry has developed a lot in India. So these are all the points which tells us that the tourism industry has developed to a great extent in India. Question number two, the quality of life and standard of living of Indian citizens is increasing. So how the quality of life and standard of living of Indian citizens is increasing? We'll see answer. First point, after India became independent, the Industrial Finance Corporation of India was established in 1948 to make available long-term loans to industrial projects. Okay, to support the industrial growth, long-term loans to the industries were given, okay, by the Finance Corporation of India. Second point, the Industrial Development Corporation was established in 1954 in order to bring about greater development of the industrial sector. Third point, due to the development of industries, many opportunities for employment become available. Okay, so as industries are developed, or as industries are set up, many people can get a job over there. So employment opportunities are available. Fourth point, on the whole, it helps in the progress of the country. Fifth, thus the standard of living in the country improves. Okay, these are all the reasons which tells us that the standard of living in the country improves. As the industries improve, the standard of the life in the country also improves. Question number 3B, answer the following in brief. First one, what efforts are made by our government to promote agricultural industries? Answer, the following efforts are made by our government to promote agriculture and industries. We'll see the points. First point, to encourage farming, loans are given to farmers through rural banks and cooperative institutions. Okay, for encouragement of the farming, loans are given, financial support is given to the farmers through rural banks and cooperative institutions. Second point, study visits, agricultural outdoor trips, and farmers get-togethers are organized to the panchayat samitis to bring about improvement in agriculture. Okay, study visits and gatherings or trainings is given to the farmers. Okay, they are taken outdoor trips for research. Okay, to the panchayat samiti to bring about the improvement in agriculture. Third point, tools and implements, seeds and fertilizers are also supplied. The farmers are given training regarding soil testing, nursery of fruit plants, pisciculture, poultry, cattle, and goat rearing, dairy farming, etc. Okay, apart from agriculture, they are given training for soil testing, nursery, food plants, pisciculture, poultry, cattle, and goat rearing and dairy farming, etc. Fourth point, guidance is given to farmers by a district level training institute. And financial help is given to build warehouses for storing the farm produce. Okay, to store their grains, financial help is given to make warehouses or store rooms for storing their farm produce. Like whatever grains they have produced, they have to keep it safely in their storage. So financial help is given to build this warehouse. So in this way, our government is helping the farmers to encourage farming. Question number two, how is employment generated in the tourism sector? The facilities for tourists to stay, travel, etc. are provided to the Tourism Development Corporation. Second point, sale of curios and the hotel industry thrives in tourist places. Third point, in some places, there are guides who give information to tourists about that area. Fourth point, sometimes when vehicles don't reach the destination in some remote areas and difficult to reach tourist places, the local people help the tourist in return for a fee. Thus, employment opportunities are generated out of these needs. Question number three, which industries in India are based on forest? Answer, first point, government has reserved some forest for the industries based on forest. Second point, the task of conservation of forests is done by the central government, the state government, and by the local people. Okay, the responsibility of the conserving of forests is on the government and on the local people. Third point, forests are necessary for the raw material. Okay, now these are the things which are based on forest. Forests are necessary for the raw material for industries like construction, paper, newsprint, silk, matchboxes, medicinal herbs, honey, lacquer, and raw material needed for the paint. All these industries depend on the forest for their raw material. The next question number four. Write a short note on leather industry in India. Answer. First point, it is a big industry in India. It is primarily export oriented. Second point, the Council for Leather Export is the main trade promotion organization for India, for Indian leather industry. Third point, the Indian leather industry contributes almost 13% of the world's leather production. Fourth point, India is the second largest production of footwear and leather garments in the world. I'll read question number 4. Read the following passage and answer the following given, answer the questions given below. So passage is about forest resources. Government has reserved some forests for the industries based on forest. The task of conservation of the forest is done by the central government, the state government, and by the local people. Forests are necessary for the raw material for industries like construction, paper, newsprint, silk, matchboxes, medicinal herbs, honey, lacquer, and raw material needed for the paint. So the question is, name few industries which depend on the upon the forest resources for their production. So the from the passage you have to search and write the answers. A few industries which depend upon forest resources are construction, newsprint, paper, and silk industry. Even lacquer is required to paint and coat furniture, honey and herbs for medicines. Answer in detail. Create a concept picture based on the chapter industries in India. So you have to write about the all industries. First point or first industries, textile industry. The textile industry forms 14% of the total industrial production. It includes the power loom and the hand loom industries. The handloom industries are labor intensive. According to the Textile Committee Act 1963, a textile committee has been established. This committee sets the quality standards for textile manufactured for the sale in the internal market as well as the S for export. So you have to write about textile industry, like it contributes 14% of total industrial production, and it includes power loom, hand loom, okay, and the textile committee sets the quality standards for textile manufactured for the sale in market, internal market, and as well as for export. Second is silk industries. The industry, this industry functions under Ministry of Textiles. Okay, silk industry comes under the Ministry of Textile Industry. The research about the species of the silkworm and the mulberry trees is done in the Seribiotic Research Laboratory at Bangalore. This industry is primarily in the states of Karnataka, Andhra Pradesh, West Bengal, Jammu and Kashmir. So these are the states where silk industry is based, and now it is being spread in the states with predominantly tribal populations, means where in a tribal area, like in forest areas also it is developed now. Silk industries are growing. Third point, jute industry. India is the top ranking country in jute production. And India is a major exporter of jute production. We get cloth, sack cloth, and ropes from the jute. So these are the items which are made from the jute, like rope, cloth, sack. Question point number four, hand sculpting. This is a labor intensive craft. Sculptors got employment due to the capacity of the craft to absorb more craftsmen, small investment, more profits, preference to export, and possibility of earning more foreign exchange. So in this industry, hand sculpting, more craftsmen are involved, like employment is, or labor is, more labors are involved. So employment is generated over here. Employment is available, and investment is also very less, and the profit is more, and possibility of earning more foreign exchange is there. Several cities have market mechanisms like the Lee Hart, which enables the craftsmen from rural and urban areas to get a market for their wares. Okay, so there's a market from where from the small villages or people come, and they will put their things for exhibition. Whatever beautiful items, craft items they made, their things are put up for the exhibition. So market mechanism is given for their wares. Fifth point is automobile industry. India is one of the major producers of vehicles. Vehicles are exported to 40 countries from India. And the automobile industry is called the sunrise sector in India. India's tractor industry is the biggest in the world, and 1/3 of the tractors manufactured worldwide are produced in India. Tractors manufactured in India are exported to Turkey, Malaysia, and several countries in Africa. So it is one of the major producer of vehicle, and it exports tractor to the other countries, and automobile industry is called as the sunrise sector. And tractors are mainly manufactured to, mainly exported to Turkey, Malaysia, and several countries in Africa. Next, sixth is cement industry. The role of cement industry is important in the development of housing and infrastructure. So, as cement is required for construction work. So the role of cement industry is important in the development of housing and infrastructure. This industry is one of the most technologically advanced. India is currently an important producer of cement in the world. Okay, this industry uses the modern technologies, and it is most technologically advanced industry in India. Next is leather industry. Seventh point is leather industry. It is a big industry in India. It is primarily export oriented. Okay. So leather industry is also the very big industry, and whatever items are made out of the leather, they are exported to the other countries. So it's primarily export oriented. Next is salt industry. India is one of the top producers of salt in the world, and the annual production of salt in India is 200 lakh tons, and the production of iodized salt is 60 lakh tons. Next is bicycle industry. India is leading producer of bicycles in the world. Bicycles are made in the states of Punjab and Tamil Nadu. So these are the states where bicycles are made. And the main center of bicycle manufacturing in India is Ludhiana, Remember this, the main center of bicycle manufacturing in India is Ludhiana. Remember it for the fill in the blank. India exports bicycles to the countries like Nigeria, Mexico, Kenya, Uganda, and Brazil. Tenth, and khadi and village industry. The Khadi and Village Industry Commission was established. Why it was established? To give impetus to industrialization in rural areas. Okay? To bring industrialization or to set up industries in rural areas, in villages. Okay? The main objective behind this establishment of the corporation were to develop the traditional industries, handicrafts that use the material and human resources available at the local level and make the villages self-reliant by creating employment over there. So this was the purpose of Khadi and Village Industry Commission. Now, again, in this question, question number two, India's imports and exports of foreign trade. So we'll see. First point, when planning started in 1951, import of industrial goods and raw material was required for increasing the production. Second point, India's import included machines, iron, mineral oil, fertilizers, medicines, etc. Third point, India also gave impetus to exports after independence in order to gain valuable foreign exchange. And last point, fourth point is India's export included tea, coffee, spices, cotton, textiles, leather, footwear, pearls, precious stones, etc. So imports and exports goods, you have to remember this comes as a concept or as a question answer. So we'll see some extra question. Okay, mineral wealth and fisheries. Fifth, question number fifth, we will see from this. Write about mineral wealth and fisheries. First point, the availability of the minerals, iron and coal, plays a major role in the industrial development of the country. Second point, we have adequate stores of iron, manganese, coal, and mineral oil in our country. Third point, fisheries include seawater, fish and fresh water, fish found in rivers, canals, ponds, and lakes. Fourth point, harbors have been built or old harbors have been redeveloped for fishing. Fish seed incubation centers and fishing industrial training centers have been provided for the growth of this industry. Question number 3A, give reason. I am reading question 3 of give reason. Agriculture fulfill man's basic needs. First point, the major occupation in India is agriculture and other tasks based on agriculture. Second point, many varieties of crops are grown like jawar, wheat, rice, pulses, and oil seeds. mainly produced, and third point, agriculture also includes the production of fruits, vegetables, and nowadays industries processing these fruits and vegetables have come up. Thus, agriculture fulfill man's basic need. Concept question number 8. Concept map is there, industries in India. So first heading you will give industries in India, and you will write which industries are the there, write the names of the industries like textile industry, silk industry, jute industry, hand sculptors, automobile industry, cement industry, leather industry, bicycle industry, and khadi. Last is khadi and village industry. And again, second is India's imports and export. So you will write imports and export. Which are the things imported and which are the things exported? Then there is explain the concept. Write short notes on number 2. Mega cluster scheme and jute industry. These are the extra questions. Just we will have a look. First point, mega cluster is a scheme that helps weavers through self-finance groups and non-governmental organization. Second, help is given in the form of raw material, design banks, development of technology, and the welfare of the weavers. And India is the top ranking country in the jute production, and India is the major exporter of the jute products, and we get cloth, sack, and ropes from the jute. Third is cement industry. The role of cement industry is important in the development of the housing and infrastructure. Second point, this industry is one of the most technologically advanced. And last point, India is currently an important producer of cement in the world. So in this way, we have revised the question answers of this lesson, and we have seen some extra and important questions also. So I'll end my lecture over here. Thank you, everyone.
Yes, teacher. Thank you. Thank you so much.